My daughter became sick and we tried, and she was on ARDS and the ARDS didn't work. And then she was found out that she's got TB, and she was treated for TB for more than 12 months. It didn't work. I went to Manzini with her because she was sick that time. And she was tested for MDR medication. I think that was in October. And we waited for the results while she was on a TB tablet, which the TB did not work because she had the MDR.
Multi-drug resistance tuberculosis is also a significant problem in Swaziland. Where you have high rates of HIV and TB, you are inevitably going to have high rates of multi-drug resistance tuberculosis, especially if it's difficult to ensure follow-up of those patients. So people have been on TB treatment before. They may not have finished, they may have not taken all the drugs for the full length of time, which creates the possibility for resistance occurring. We do know now that a lot of multi-drug resistance tuberculosis in Swaziland is actually spread directly. In other words, it's not resistance developing in someone that's already had tuberculosis, it's new cases that are resistant right from the start.
We waited and waited, I think that was October, and then towards the end of November she died. Whew. After receiving the report that my daughter died on MDR, I nearly had a stroke because I was worried every day, blaming whom to blame, whom to blame. I didn't know whom to blame because I got that she was tested in time, but I was told that the results will come after six weeks. 6 weeks came, 2 months came, 3 months came, 4 months came. That time she was dead already.
The case of Briget's daughter is sadly all too common. In fact, in the majority of the world, people don't even have access to the right tools to diagnose multi-drug resistant TB. And then even in places that do have diagnosis, the majority of them, it takes weeks or months to diagnose. We're currently rolling out this new tool, which is really exciting because it helps us diagnose a lot of patients a lot quicker with MDR-TB. The problem is that this tests that we're rolling out at the moment in our TB programs do rely on a constant electricity supply, which really does limit where we can introduce this test. Well, the current international gold standard for MDR-TB treatment, unfortunately, is about a 2-year treatment. That treatment involves people taking a large number of pills every day and a minimum of 8 months of daily injections. And that's a huge ask for patients.
Yabona ngona vele ngalokuthi vele usuke uphathekile futhi kusuke kufanele lokuthi ujikise naso ukuthi wavele unalokugula kude longasenza ukujikise.
Many patients will actually go partially or even completely deaf. Other side effects that can happen is losing your feeling in your legs. You can have problems with your thinking, and some people even become quite depressed or suicidal. So there's many really serious and sometimes even life-threatening side effects just from taking what's supposed to be a cure.
Good day, Snowend. Ngeke futhi ukhona ukuguqula ngoba vele kusho ukuthi usuke phela ekliniki kwalengadi lokuthi kube khona le mvuka loyile vuka kona emtimbeni manje sangathi lesi sibe side esikhathi ke ngikhalisa vele kakhulu ngiko leyo kungathi kuyinkinga siba side kakhulu nesikhathi yesi.
The success rate in most programs is around 60%. Some programs get a little bit better. But overall, still a lot of people can't take the treatment for the whole time, and there's still a high number of people dying or failing treatment and getting even more resistant TB. And really this is, you know, not acceptable. We need a regimen that has less side effects, is much better tolerated by people. We need a regimen that acts really quickly, especially for patients who have HIV and MDR-TB co-infection. We want to reduce that risk of early death, and we need a regimen that can be given in a much shorter time period. 2 years is too long. We should be thinking about 6 months or even less treatment for MDR-TB. There are some new drugs in the pipeline. We need to think now, how are we going to take new drugs and create a new regimen?